U.S. Navy and the Missile Defense Agency successfully completed two flight test missions. The latest successful tests of the second-generation Aegis Ballistic Missile Defense System 4.0, including the BMD signal processor and standard missile 3 Block 1B. In back-to-back missions, the system engaged and intercepted a complex, short-range ballistic missile target and a medium-range ballistic missile target. From the very first flight test, Aegis BMD has made a priority of ensuring that the flight tests are operationally realistic, conducted under simulated operational scenarios with tactically configured systems operated by fleet sailors. During these events, Commander U.S. Navy Operational Test and Evaluation Force continued the operational assessment of the BMD 4.0 weapon system and SM-3 Block 1B. This assessment will support an upcoming full-rate production decision by the Missile Defense Executive Board. Prior tests of the second-generation Aegis BMD system have examined performance against a unitary target, a separating target, and a sophisticated separating target with a complex debris scene. These missions continue with a more complex, sophisticated separating target and a medium-range ballistic missile target. Increasing test complexity enhances operator knowledge and system confidence, and ensures the system will perform successfully under operational conditions. The first mission, Flight Test Mission 21, was conducted on September 18, 2013. This mission assessed system performance by engaging an Aegis Readiness Assessment Vehicle C target, a short-range ballistic missile target which incorporates a separating mock warhead. During this test, an employment of a salvo size 2 firing policy of the SM-3 was the primary objective of the mission, where two missiles are fired at a single target. A U.S. Navy Aegis cruiser is positioned more than 250 nautical miles off the coast of Kauai, conducting a simulated BMD station patrol. The ship uses simulated operational intelligence to configure the Aegis weapon system to protect the assigned defended area. Based on mission planner outputs, the sailors program the SPY-1 radar to perform a search optimized for their assigned ballistic missile defense mission. From their simulated operational guidance, the crew configures firing policy for a salvo size 2 engagement. The crew is not informed of the launch time. The ARAV-C target is launched from the Pacific Missile Range facility on the island of Kauai. The target flies a representative trajectory, and the mock warhead separates from the booster. As the target rises above the horizon, the SPY-1 radar acquires and tracks the target. The Aegis Ballistic Missile Defense Weapon System develops a fire control solution, and the crew monitors preparations for the salvo size 2 firing policy of the SM-3s. Several minutes after target launch, the weapon system fires two standard missile 3 Block 1Bs. The missiles complete booster burn and separation, followed by second stage rocket motor burn and separation. Airborne cameras track the missiles throughout most of their flight. The weapon system provides guidance commands to the missiles. After second stage separation, the third stage rocket motors ignite, propelling the missiles out of the atmosphere and into space. After third stage pulse 1 burns out, the missiles eject their nose cones, then ignite third stage pulse 2. The Aegis Ballistic Missile Defense Weapon System provides a final update to the missiles, based upon the most precise information from the SPY-1 radar and BMD signal processor. The kinetic warheads are ejected from the third stage. After separation, the throttle divert and attitude control system ignites and stabilizes the kinetic warheads. The infrared seekers, informed by information previously received from the ship, select the target and calculate final divert and attitude control system commands to close the target. The target image grows in the seeker field of view. The two-color seeker, advanced signal processor, and improved divert and attitude control system guide the kinetic warhead to intercept. Mark India, a direct hit. The first missile in the salvo destroys the target. Testing continued with the second mission, Flight Test Mission 22, conducted on October 3, 2013. This mission examined system performance by engaging an Aegis Readiness Assessment Vehicle Extended Range Target, a medium-range ballistic missile target which incorporates a separating Mach warhead. The U.S. Navy Aegis cruiser continues its simulated operational patrol off the coast of Kauai. The crew is not informed of the launch time, but remains vigilant to protect the assigned defended area from all threats. The ARAV extended range target is launched from the Pacific Missile Range facility on the island of Kauai. The target flies a representative trajectory, and the Mach warhead separates from the booster. As the target rises above the horizon, the SPY-1 radar acquires and tracks the target. The Aegis Ballistic Missile Defense Weapon System develops a fire control solution, and the crew monitors preparations for the SM-3 launch. Several minutes after target launch, the weapon system fires the Standard Missile 3 Block 1B. The missile completes booster burn and separation, followed by second stage rocket motor burn and separation. Airborne cameras track the missile throughout most of its flight. During flyout, the weapon system provides guidance commands to the missile. After second stage separation, the third stage rocket motor ignites, propelling the missile out of the atmosphere and into space. After third stage pulse one burns out, the missile ejects its nose cone, then ignites third stage pulse two. The Aegis Ballistic Missile Defense Weapon System provides a final update to the missile, based upon the most precise information from the SPY-1 radar and BMD signal processor. The kinetic warhead is ejected from the third stage. After separation, the infrared seeker, informed by information previously received from the ship, selects the target and calculates final divert and attitude control system commands to close the target. As range decreases, the target image grows in the seeker field of view. The two-color seeker, advanced signal processor, and improved divert and attitude control system guide the kinetic warhead to intercept. Mark India, a direct hit. These tests demonstrated the system's ability to acquire, track, and engage a medium-range ballistic missile warhead under operational conditions. Numerous ground, sea, and air-based platforms observed the intercepts. The energy from the impacts is calculated to be in excess of 125 megajoules, equivalent to a 10-ton truck traveling 600 miles per hour. Two more successful intercepts for Aegis Ballistic Missile Defense. These were the fourth and fifth successful intercept tests using the Aegis Ballistic Missile Defense 4.0 weapon system, including the Ballistic Missile Defense Signal Processor and the Standard Missile 3 Block 1B missile. The engagements were performed under strict operational testing conditions and again validated the fleet's ability to conduct operational planning, operate and maintain the weapon system, and successfully intercept threat realistic targets. Test results also inform fleet training and operational employment doctrine. These tests complete requirements for the full rate production decision and approval for operational deployment, pending a report from Commander Operational Test and Evaluation Force. The Missile Defense Agency and the U.S. Navy are continuing to improve and deploy the Aegis Ballistic Missile Defense capability in support of global deployment requirements. Aegis Ballistic Missile Defense. We deliver.